is the generation that has seen all of it, both sides of the spectrum. Or you can say all the angles, the good and the ugly. And what I'm talking about social media, as you can probably tell from the title. We have seen the transition from no social media at all to people making careers out of it. We have seen people not interacting with each other at all to talking to strangers. We have seen everything, in short. And we have also seen no social media at all to it having so many outlets now and it being so massive. And then there are two types of people. Number one, who think that social media is all bad and it should be banned, it should not be there because it's the core cause of all the evils in society. And number two are people who think that it's all positive. It is there because it's good. But if you zoom out and look at things, you will realize that both of these people realize that social media has both pros and cons. So why not lay everything on the table and talk about it? In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some pros and cons of social media. Let's start with the pros because positivity, it's something that we all want to achieve, right? So let's begin. Number one, awareness through sites and people you follow on social media. And I have seen this happening quite recently in the recent events, and I'm going to give you examples, don't worry. Social media is a great tool for spreading information and spreading awareness among the masses. One example is Black Lives Matter, and people really did their part in educating the other people who didn't really have any idea of what is happening. And the second example is more recent, it's the US elections. I have seen young people, young influencers, pushing their audience to go out and vote, and it's so awesome. Number two is career and job opportunities. So I think that social media has brought along a really wide variety of job opportunities for people, and it has become a career for so many people. After so many years, people have now accepted the fact that social media can be your job, can be a career. Number three is very obvious. It's interacting with people and finding new friends. And it's such a cool opportunity to meet different people of different backgrounds, different countries. Now, like, it literally feels as if the world has become a global village because now you have people of different countries and different origins and different places or whatever at the tip of your fingers, and you can literally connect with them and become friends with them. Number four is donations during crisis or illness. And it's so incredible and it's so impactful as well. I think that through social media, it has become possible to reach global audience and reach massive amount of people for donations for during a time of crisis or during a time of illness, especially what happened in the explosion in Lebanon. I think social media has made it possible for the money to get to the right people and get to the right causes. Number five is awareness about different illnesses, be it mental or physical. And I have also seen a couple of, or not even a couple of, many YouTubers who suffer from different diseases and they have their own channels, and it just makes the audience aware about the situation, and it makes people understand how these people live their lives and how to treat them when you meet them in public, or how to help them if you find someone with that disease in public. And it's really, really incredible and really educating us. And number six is social media eases loneliness, and it was seen especially during COVID period because everyone was in isolation and you couldn't just take up your car and go meet a friend or talk to someone. But social media made it possible because it's again something that you can do while sitting at home, and that was one of the positives of social media, that you can talk to other people while staying at home, and it connected so many people because people were really feeling lonely and people really were feeling depressed or anxious about the things that are going, so they connected with a lot of people on these issues. Now let's talk about the cons. Number one is cyberbullying, and it's something that's really obvious and really prevalent and increasing at the moment. Everyone knows that it's wrong, but you really can't do anything to prevent it. It's really easy to sit behind a screen and type, but all of these things come from people who have some inner insecurities. But cyberbullying is really ruining lives of people, and it should be stopped. And same goes with real life bullying. Everyone knows that it's wrong, but no one can really do anything about it. I think that there are some evils in the society that are known that they are evil, but you can't really do anything to prevent it. Number two is spreading of false information And again, it's the opposite of spreading awareness. It's really, really easy to spread rumors on social media, and it has happened so many times as well. And it just really happens when someone hears something and without fact checking, they put it online and it just spreads like a wildfire. Number three is addicting. It's addicting, let's be honest. How many times do you go on your phone and just scroll down your timeline because you are just bored? Number four is it can cause impulsive buying, and it's something that I have seen a lot of people complaining about. A lot of the times it happens that you are scrolling down your timeline on YouTube or Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, and then you come across an ad and you are like, okay, I'm just gonna buy it. That's impulsive buying, and it could lead to impulsive spending too. And number five is if it's not used correctly, then it could lead to invasion of privacy. And it's something that's happening more and more these days. So it's really important for you to take precaution and to just be cautious everywhere and try to protect yourself as much as possible. Try to protect your content. So those were some pros and cons, and obviously they are pretty obvious ones, but I just wanted to lay everything out on the table and discuss it, because I feel like if you balance some things out, then we can potentially reach a balance in the usage of social media. And if you struggle with the addicting part of social media, there are some things that could help you. With the advancement in the technology used in social media, the technology that's used in phones and all that kind of stuff also advanced. And now there is this option of controlling the amount of time that you spend on an app. It's a pretty old function, but you can use it. If you didn't know about that, then here you go. And that's it for this video. Let's have a discussion in the comments below. What do you think about these pros and cons? And if you have anything to add, do tell me in the comments below. Give this video a thumbs up if you haven't already, and subscribe. It will mean the world to me. And also, if you want to, you can follow me on my socials. And I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care. God bless you. Assalamu alaikum. Bye.